Assalamu alaikum, dear students. Welcome to NITS Home School. Hope we all are well by the grace of Almighty Allah. Here I am Kamal, assistant teacher of English National IELTS Preparatory School, Deshi. Today I am going to take the English language class for the students of class 4. And our today's topic is comprehension of text. And in our previous class, we have discussed about the structures of the tenses, which is very important to this topic. And if you have any confusion, you can go through this video. And today we will solve some examples to clear our concept. Let's start. We will change the tenses according to the direction. And number one, he is playing cricket, and we will change it to present indefinite tense. Now look at this sentence. Here is if after the subject and verb with ing. So this is in the present continuous form. So we will write the subject here. Subject will be same he, and according to the structure, we will write the base form of the verb play. So we will write here play, and our subject is third person singular number. So we will add s here. And now the rest of the sentence, cricket. We will write here cricket. Now it's done. Now number two. They went to market. We will change it to present continuous tense. And now look at this verb went. It is in the past form. The past form of verb go. So we need to change it. And our subject is they. And according to the structure, after they, we will write here are for present continuous tense, because our subject is plural and we use are after the plural subject. Now the verb with ing, and go is the present form of the verb went, and we will add ing here. They are going, now the rest of the sentence, to market. Now number three. We visited this place. We will change it to present perfect tense. And now look at this verb, visited. It is in the past form. So this sentence is in the past indefinite tense. And now we will change it. Our subject is we. We will write here we. And we will write have after we, because our subject is plural. We use have after the plural subject and after I. So we have now the past participle form of the verb. And the past participle form of the verb visit is the same visited. That means visit, visited, visited. And now the rest of the sentence or extension, this place. Now number four. She teaches us English. We will change it to present perfect continuous tense. And now look. Teaches, that means we use es after this verb teach. That means it is in the present indefinite tense. So we will change it to present perfect continuous tense. So our subject is she, and after she we will write here it has been, because our subject is third person singular number and we use has after the third person singular number. She has been, now the past participle form of the, we will write the verb with ing. Now, T-E-A-C-H-I-N-G. Teaching, now the extension as English. So, it's done. Now, number five. Habib leaves the country. We will change it to past indefinite tense. Now look at this verb leaves. We add s after the verb. At the end of the verb, and it is in the the past form. And what you get? H A B I B. Abib. Now the past form of the verb lived will be lived. Abib lived. Now the rest of the sentence. The country. Now number six. I have read the book. We will change it to past form yourself. Now look at this verb had. We use had after the past perfect tense. And now we will change it to past continuous. So we will write here I, and after I we will write was. Because according to the structure, after the singular subject we use was in the past continuous tense. And now the verb with ing, R-E-A-D-I-N-G. Reading, I was reading. Now the extension, the book. And now number 7. We don't need the word. We will change it to past perfect tense. And now look at this verb, did. It is in the past form. It is the past form of the verb, do. So we will change it to past perfect tense. Our subject is written. And we will write here, had. And we can use had after the subject. I mean, whether it is singular or plural, it doesn't matter. We will use here had. Written had. Now the past participle form of the verb, that means done. Done is the past participle form of the verb do. Rita had done. Now the extension, the verb. And now the last one, number 8. He is flying a kite since morning. We will change it to past perfect continuous tense. Now look at this verb is and flying. After the subject there is is and verb ing. That means it is the present continuous tense. And now we will change it. Our subject is he. And for past perfect continuous tense we will write here had been. So we can use had after singular or plural subject. That means it is for both singular and plural subject. So he had been. Now verb in ing. Flying. And the rest of the sentence.